In this video, we're going to work through an example involving parametric equations of lines. So here are instructions. Find a parametric representation of the line 2x minus 3y equals 5. And actually what we're going to do is we're going to find three or four different parametric representations of this line to emphasize the fact that these parametric representations are not unique. So then out to the side here, to help us out a little bit, I've just copied down a summary of the forms of the parametric equations of a line. So if you recall, we have x equals x0 plus at and y equals y0 plus bt for t between negative infinity and infinity. And this is one way to represent a line parametrically. And in this notation, the slope of our line is going to be b over a, and the line is going to pass through the point x0, y0. So we're going to actually use this form of the line to write down our first parametric representation. So what we're going to do here basically is if we look at this representation of the line here that I have out to the side, we've got these constants a and b, which come from the slope of the line, and then these constants x0, y0, which just come from some point that the line passes through. So we can take this 2x minus 3y equals 5, find the slope, find a point that it passes through, and then just plug that information into this parametric form. So that's what we're going to start by doing. So I've got 2x minus 3y equals 5, and I want to find the slope of this line. So probably the most straightforward way to do this is just to solve this equation for y so that we get it into y equals mx plus b form. So if I do that, I'm going to get 2x minus 5 equals 3y, and then I can divide everything by 3 and get y equals 2/3 x minus 5/3. So from this form here, I can easily read off the slope of the line. It's just, of course, 2/3. And then I can also find a point that the line passes through. Now, of course, there are infinitely many points that this line passes through. I just need to pick one. So perhaps an easy thing to do would be to let x equals 1. And then I would have 2/3 minus 5/3. Which would give me negative 1. So now we're just going to take this information and plug it in to this parametric form of the line. So once again, in this parametric form over here, the slope of the line is b over a. My slope, I know, should be 2/3. So then what I can do is I can just let 2 equal b and 3 equal a. And then I'm passing through the point x0, y0. So 1 is going to be my x0, and negative 1 is going to be my y0. So plugging in all that information, I get x equals 1 plus 3t, and then y equals y0, which is negative 1, plus bt, or 2t. And then we'll let t go between negative infinity and infinity to trace out the entire line. So let's just check ourselves, just for this first representation, just to make sure we're on the right track. So how could we check ourselves? Well, we could actually just plot some points and see if this looks like a line, and specifically if it looks like this line y equals 2/3 x minus 5/3. So to do this, we would create a table of values for just a few different t values. So here I've gone ahead and created a chart. I've just taken several different t values, plugged them into x and y to get some points. And now we can take these x, y points and plot them, and we would get something that looks like this. Okay, now if we are correct, then Our line should have a slope of 2/3 and a y-intercept of negative 5/3. So slope of 2/3, if I pick two points here, I should have a rise of 2, 1, 2, and run 1, 2, 3, so that looks good. And I could believe that my y-intercept was negative 5/3. So it looks like this is a correct parametric representation of the line. So now what we're going to do is find some other equivalent representations of the line. And there are a few different ways we can go about that. So one equivalent representation would be building off of our first representation here. I could simply write the slope as 4/6 instead of 2/3. And I could still have my line going through the point, one negative one. Although I also could pick a different point and have a different representation because of that. But anyway, if I go from here, so now my b is going to be 4 and my a is going to be 6, I could write my equations as the following. 1 plus 6t and then y equals negative 1 plus 4t for t's between negative infinity and infinity. And that would trace out the same line. I should note, though, that though this does trace out the same line, when you use a different representation, it could be that the line would be traced out at a different rate, which would be the case here, or it might be traced out in a different orientation. Okay, so the rate and orientation of the parametric curve can change when you use a different representation. So keep that in mind. Now, of course, you could also check yourself for this representation in the same way we did before, by plotting some points, but I'm not going to show that in this example. Now, really quickly, we're just going to look at one more way to represent this line parametrically. So let me go back to my original equation, my original Cartesian equation, 2x minus 5y sorry, 2x minus 3y equals 5. Now, another really kind of simple way I could represent this parametrically is I could start by just saying let x equal t. Okay, so if I then plug that x equals t into here, I'm going to get 2t minus 3y equals 5. And then I can solve this for y. So 2t minus 5 equals 3y. Or 2/3 t minus 5/3 equals y. So then I could simply represent this line parametrically by the equations x equals t and y equals 2/3 t minus 5/3. For, once again, t's between negative infinity and infinity. And once again, you could check this by plotting points, and you would see that it indeed does represent this line. So that's just one other way you can go about representing a line parametrically. But just note that this, even in this form here, this representation here, this still actually does match our general form for parametric lines, right? Because our form is x equals x0 plus at, y equals y0 plus bt, and that parametric line has a slope of b over a. Now, what's b over a over here? Well, b is 2/3, and a is 1. All right, so I get slope of 2/3, and in this representation, I'm passing through the point x0, y0. So here, x0 is just 0. And y0 is this negative 5/3. Okay, so then this parametric representation gives me a line with slope 2/3 passing through the point 0, negative 5/3, and that matches up with our line up here. Right, so even though we went about this finding this representation differently, it still agrees with this general form we've been learning about.